Do you suffer from nosebleeding? This is how to handle it. Hello everyone, welcome to Alema Health Matters. If you are new here, kindly subscribe. You can also share this video and also like. Let's take care of our health together. Our today's objectives, we have four main objectives where we will be basing our discussions on. The first one is the five common causes of nosebleeding. Number two is five basic preventive measures for nosebleeding. Number three is four steps in what to do in case of a nosebleeding episode. And lastly, we will be discussing on what to limit or to avoid for at least 5 days after a nosebleeding episode. Stay tuned. Let's talk about the causes. We have many causes that can cause a nosebleeding episode, but today we will only be focusing on the five common causes. And the first one is trauma. Trauma is a very common cause. Mostly it's due to nose picking or by forcibly blowing the nose. These are common practices in our day-to-day lives. The second cause is drugs. Over-the-counter drugs like aspirin can cause a nosebleeding episode. Thirdly, we have chronic infections of the sinus, like the sinusitis. If you suffer from this kind of an infection, you can experience a nosebleeding episode. Also, exposure to irritants, and lastly, allergies. Now let's discuss about the basic preventive measures for a nosebleeding episode. You can do this if you frequently suffer from nosebleeding. Number one, you should avoid picking the nose and keep the fingernails trimmed and short. Number two, if you are a smoker, you should focus on quitting smoking or avoiding the smoking. Number three, you should also avoid blowing one nostril, but instead blow both nostrils at the same time to balance or equalize the pressure. Number four, you should use saline nasal drops or sprayer to keep the nostrils moist. And lastly, you should avoid using cold or allergy medications too often. Now, what are the steps that we should take in case we experience a nosebleeding episode? Step number one, you should sit up and lean forward. You do that, you are still experiencing the bleeding, you move to step number two. Step number two is about applying pressure on the bridge of the nose for at least 10 to 15 minutes to stop the blood flow. You do this, you are still bleeding, you move to step number three, whereby now here you are going to apply some secondary measures like spraying the nose with a nose decongestant. You do that, you are still bleeding, you move to step number four. Here you soak a cotton ball with the nasal spray and insert it into your nose, and then you press. These are the four major steps that you can do, but also you can gently blow the nose. It also helps in decreasing or stopping the nose bleeding. So do these steps. You can do them at the comfort of your homes, and they help if you among the people who experience frequently nosebleeding episodes. Then there are some things or activities you should avoid or limit after you experience a nosebleeding episode for at least 5 days. What are these things? What are these activities? Number one, You should avoid taking very hot showers. You should also avoid heavy lifting. You should also avoid straining activities. You should also avoid hot, spicy foods. And lastly, you should avoid medications like aspirin. These are the things that you should avoid for at least 5 days after an episode of nosebleeding. That is our last session for this presentation. Kindly, if you are new, subscribe to my channel for more exciting videos like this, so that we can continue taking care of our health together. You can also share this video so that it can help someone somewhere, and I will appreciate it. Thank you very much.